Welcome! This video is about how to make Gyokugan. This is the ancient style of creating the eyes that are found in many Buddhist sculptures from Japan. This video will show the basic construction of a Gyokugan style eye using techniques which were perfected nearly 1,000 years ago. The main ingredient from the original techniques are sculpted and polished lenses made of rock crystal, which are then painted and set from the inside of a sculpture's head. The components may look a little complex, but the process is almost deceptively simple. We're going to be changing the materials a little bit, using common items that are low cost and easy to come by. This is a hollowed out eye socket sculpted in wood, which has been shaped to fit the curved end of a plastic spoon. After cutting the handles off of two spoons, red fingernail polish is painted in each corner of one lens. This is to simulate the blood flow of an eyeball. In the past, red or blue colored papers were pressed into the corners of the lens. The pupils are directly poured into the second lens with black model paint. An eyedropper may be used for better control. The paint may require several days to completely dry. For the iris around the pupil, colored foil from candy wrappers work very well. For pure silver, heavy-duty aluminum foil is perfect. To cut a perfectly round iris, a diverse coin collection is handy. Domestic U.S. coins have a good variety of sizes, but a few foreign coins can offer valuable alternate sizes and shapes. Here, a U.S. nickel is used to cut the first layer. On a cutting surface, don't let any pressure off the coin until the foil has been completely cut. In the past, materials included gold foil, colored silk, and sometimes paint. To attach the iris layers, black fingernail polish can be used as glue. The artist is allowed several seconds to work before the polish dries. The sensitive positioning can be adjusted by looking through the front of the lens. A couple of wrinkles here and there can assist in adding a little bit of extra detail in the eye. Almost immediately, the next layer of foil can be applied in exactly the same way. After gluing the final layer of foil, a black line is painted around the outer edge, which gives the eye a little extra bit of depth. After everything has dried, the Gyokugan is ready to assemble. The white cotton from a medicine bottle will be the white part of the eye. The wooden pegs and a small piece of wood will be used to hold everything in place. Here is the final layering of the materials, which will be inserted into the eye socket. Insert each component individually and always double-check the positioning. Insert the lens with the red nail polish, and then the painted lens. Foreign particles can easily become trapped between the two lenses. Next, the cotton and wood backer are added. Sometimes paper was used instead of cotton. Here, broken toothpicks are used to hold everything in place. In the past, materials included bamboo pegs and sometimes iron nails. And here is the completed Gyokugan eye. When seen from any angle, the two layers of thin plastic spoon create an impressive amount of depth. Although the spoons may not be a rock crystal lens, this technique is very much the same as what has been used for many years, and the glossy plastic surface reflects light very nicely. If you decide to use this technique for your sculpture, feel free to post a link to your artwork. Thank you for watching.